and welcome to another episode of Erongo Talk. Today we are joining you from the Casa Mia Hotel in Walvis Bay. My name is Leandrea Louw and I'll be your host for today. Now, as usual, I'm going to bring you the latest news, the weather and tides, and our interview for today is with the co-owner of Mondesa Knitting Project, Toini Gabriel. Now, the entrepreneur talks about how the business has helped her to be sustainable and how COSDEC has helped the business to thrive. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back after this. For your news, brought to you from the Casa Mia Hotel. Now, World Dementia Day with Let's Talk About Dementia as the theme was observed at the Alzheimer's and Dementia Namibia facility situated on the outskirts of Swakopmund over the weekend. Now, an estimated 8,000 people in Namibia live with dementia. Now, Deputy Minister of Health and Social Services, Esther Minwangui, who was the guest of honour at the occasion, said that there is a lack of knowledge and information about the condition. Now, many people with dementia in Namibia are considered cursed or possessed. It is important to collaborate and navigate a path of creating more awareness and education about dementia, she said, expressing her appreciation for the good work done by ADN. Now, ADN was founded by Barry Holzhausen, the founding member of the Michelle Group, discovered the Namibia lacked a facility to care for people with Alzheimer's and other types of dementia. Now, the Michelle Group was founded in January 2009 after a car accident involving a 16-year-old girl and a drunk driver. Now, the 16-year-old girl, whose name is Michelle. Michelle had a heart for old people and outsiders. It was decided to create a fund in her honor and in support of the people she loved and cared for. Now, the entire month of September was declared as Alzheimer's Month in 2012, with 21 September being celebrated as World Dementia Day around the world. Now, this is an international campaign aimed at raising awareness and challenging stigma and discrimination associated with dementia, an umbrella term for several diseases affecting memory as well as other cognitive abilities and behavior that interfere significantly with people's ability to manage their daily activities. Now, in another story, former Brave Warriors pays tribute to Seth Boyce. Former Namibian national goalkeeper Denzel Brouwer paid tribute to the former Brave Warriors coach and NFA technical director Seth Boyce, who was 60 years old, who passed away recently. Now, Brouwer said that he had played the best match of his career under the leadership of Boyce. Now, Brouwer was awarded the Man of the Match accolade for his performance in the 1998 COSAFA, that's the Council of Southern Africa Football Association's Castle Cup match in Lusaka against Zambia. And he said, and I quote, "That was my second game for Namibia and he was the coach. The game ended in a 1-1 stalemate. I have fond memories of him," said Brouwer. Now, furthermore, the former goalkeeper hailed Boyce as a disciplined and straightforward person and coach from whom he learned a lot. Now, former Brave Warriors captain Sandra De Govia said that although he was never coached by Boyce, he played for Blue Waters against the team he was coaching at the time, which was Orlando Pirates. "I remember him as a gentleman and a humble person. Even though I was an opponent in another team, I remember him encouraging and complimenting me. His advice and encouragement meant a lot to me in my soccer career. In particular, he was fond of my long passes, especially the 45-degree pass behind the defense, which he said was quite unique and caused his team problems." Now, Boyce trained in Brazil and Germany as a coach and took charge of the Brave Warriors between 1998 and 1999. He coached the squad for 7 matches. Now, Namibia recorded 3 victories, 3 losses, and a draw under his mentorship. He also coached the national under-23 team for 11 matches. Now, and furthermore, The Minister of Environment, Forestry and Tourism, Boamba Shifeta, said his ministry takes pride in the fact that Namibia is home to the largest population of black rhino in the world. Now, he said this since we celebrated World Rhino Day yesterday. Now, the country has a third of the entire remaining black rhino on the planet and the second largest white rhino population in the world after South Africa. Namibia also has the largest population of black rhinos within a protected area and the largest free-roaming black rhino population in the world. Now, he said approximately 93% of the total population of this taxon are found in Namibia as at the 31st of December 2019, and rhino numbers are increasing steadily under a well-established and innovative conservation and management program, Shifeta said. Now, furthermore, despite these achievements, Namibia's rhino conservation remains challenged by incidences of poaching. Now, this is even though Namibia has seen a decline in poaching numbers as a result of ongoing intervention by government, communal conservancies, private custodians and NGOs. However, poaching patterns are highly dynamic and any amount of poaching remains a major concern to the ministry. Now, the minister pointed out that in this regard, the ministry and its partners have carried out a series of proactive measures designed to prevent poaching. Now, he furthermore, he said that law enforcement and intelligence has been key in reducing the threat of poaching. Now, he said that national security forces were also deployed in the Etosha National Park to counter rhino poaching. Now, this is in addition to a new division that was created by the ministry to deal exclusively with wildlife protection, intelligence and investigations. But you can definitely read more on this story and so much more on our website at www.erongo.com.na. That's www.erongo.com.na. And that concludes your news.
Mile 4 Caravan Park and Seaside Hotel presents the first Lockdown Lift Family Fun Day. Come and join us on Saturday, 26 September from 10 to 5. We will have a fishing competition with prizes for the biggest shark, the biggest edible fish, the weirdest fish, and the biggest fish for a girl and a boy under 10 years of age. We will host a 5-a-side action cricket and a 3-a-side volleyball tournament with prizes to be won. Grab something to eat or have a drink at our cash bar. Join us at the tent while Werner van Zyl entertain you with live music and your kids jump on the bouncy castles. Entrance is $20 per adult and $10 per kid. Don't miss this exciting day and bring all your friends.
We are here at the COSDEC Incubation Center, joined by one of the entrepreneurs. Can you please introduce yourself, Mama?
Okay,
She says her name is Toini Gabriel and she works with her business called Mondesa Knitting Project.
All right. What kind of business do you do, Ms. Toini, and why did you decide to do this kind of business?
My friend wanted to get a tiny, or where I could be a
I'm going to go to the school.
So she started the business after she received training from a lady called Beata Itembu, who was based in Bentuk. They are actually four in business. And after that, they got a space here in COSDEC, and they also got an opportunity to get items, materials such as the wool to help them with their business, and equipment as well, and business training and mentorship. And she believes that COSDEC has really helped her, you know, with the business.
How does this make you feel to have received all this training and all this to have received the training as well as the opportunity to have your business here?
They are really grateful and happy because before that they had no one to actually show them and direct them to say this is how you're supposed to run the business and this is what you're supposed to do. So they are really happy and grateful.
And now that school has started for most of the grades or all the grades, how do you think your business is going to help the community at large?
So now that some of the classes have started for some schools, it will actually help them, you know, to run their businesses again. And there's already some orders, they're receiving orders already for school jerseys, and they just need to get more wool so that they can actually start making more jerseys. But they are already receiving orders and they are happy to help make more jerseys.
How does this opportunity to come and have or to have this business and also to be helped through COSDEC, how has it helped your personal life in terms of providing for your family and so on, and just to make a living?
The business has really helped them a lot, and it's really moving forward. Despite, you know, the COVID-19 pandemic, they still are able to move forward and grow the business.
Right. Miss, tell us, what is your closing remarks? Anything else that you didn't mention that you want to say?
They are actually really grateful and that what COSDEC has done for them and for all the training and the assistance they have, because they actually had no idea where to go and what to do. So they are really grateful.
Thank you very much.
And now for your weather and tides, kicking off with the tides, we had high tide this morning at 20 minutes to 8, low tide will be at 10 minutes to 2, and then high tide again at 10 minutes past 8 this evening, and then low tide will be at 2 o'clock tomorrow morning. And then for your temperatures, Walvis Bay sunrise was this morning at 10 minutes to 7, sunset will be at 2 minutes to 7 this afternoon. A maximum temperature of 19 degrees Celsius is expected for today with a westerly wind, and then for tomorrow a minimum of 13 degrees Celsius and a maximum of 19 degrees Celsius. Swakopmund sunrise was this morning at 10 minutes to 7, sunset will also be at 2 minutes to 7. Maximum temperature for today will be 17 degrees Celsius with a westerly wind. And then for tomorrow, a minimum of 14 degrees Celsius and a maximum of 18 degrees Celsius. For Antis Bay, sunrise was this morning at 9 minutes to 7. Sunset will be at 1 minute to 7 this evening. Maximum temperature for today is expected at 18 degrees Celsius with a west-north westerly wind. And then for tomorrow, a minimum of 14 degrees Celsius and a maximum of 18 degrees Celsius. For Aranda, sunrise was this morning at 12 minutes to 7. Sunset will be at 3 minutes to 7 this evening. Maximum temperature for today is 27 degrees Celsius with a south-southwesterly wind. For tomorrow, a minimum of 11 degrees Celsius and a maximum of 28 degrees Celsius. For Usakos, sunrise was also this morning at 12 minutes to 7. Sunset will be at 3 minutes to 7 this evening. A maximum temperature of 38 degrees Celsius is expected for today with a north-northwesterly wind. For tomorrow, a minimum of 12 degrees Celsius and a maximum of 37 degrees Celsius. For Karibab, sunrise was this morning at 6:45. Sunset will be at 7 minutes to 7. Maximum temperature for today will be 37 degrees Celsius with a north-northwesterly wind. For tomorrow, a minimum of 14 degrees Celsius and a maximum of 36 degrees Celsius. And finally, for Oamaruru, sunrise was this morning at 16 minutes to 7. Sunset will be at 7 minutes to 7 this evening. A maximum temperature of 37 degrees Celsius is expected for today with a northeasterly wind. And then for tomorrow, a minimum of 14 degrees Celsius and a maximum of 37 degrees Celsius. So it's quite cold along the coast and quite warm or hot in the inland. So please prepare accordingly. That's your weather and tides for today and tomorrow. Unfortunately, that brings us to the end of today's episode of Erongo Talk, but you can still check out our website at www.erongo.com.na. That's www.erongo.com.na, where you will find all the latest news happening here in the region. You can also follow us on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram, or say hi to us or let us know what's happening in your community by sending us news tips or videos or photos at 0811-7040. That's 0811-7040. If you also want to get in contact with us for advertisement opportunities, that's the number to dial. So please, let's take care of ourselves. It doesn't mean because the state of emergency has ended that COVID-19 has also ended. Wear your mask, sanitize your hands, keep your social distancing. The only way we can get rid of COVID-19 is if we take care of ourselves. So tomorrow we'll be back again at 12 o'clock, but my colleague Arif Kaure will be joining you from Swakopmund. So until tomorrow, bye.